DNA Painter is a powerful resource for helping you better understand your DNA matches and relationships. Hi, I'm Sunny Jane Morton with Family Tree Magazine, here with a quick tour of DNA Painter. As you can see, I have logged in at DNA Painter with my free account. On my dashboard, I can see three categories: ancestral trees, tools and Watto, and chromosome maps. I'm just going to give you an introduction to these first two today. Let's start with my tree. I have created not a master family tree where I do all of my research, but a reference tree for DNA purposes. I use this tree to track and visualize key genetic information. I like being able to mark the ones who are my genetic ancestors, meaning that I have DNA matches who support my descent from this person. I can also click to view a profile here, and when I do, I can see that I have some information on Barbara's mtDNA haplogroup. She did not test, she is deceased, but as her maternal granddaughter, my test results got entered in this tree and were automatically populated to every woman for whom they apply, and so the results come here. Something else fun that you can do here on these trees is to add a dimension with lots of different parameters. You can choose one parameter to explore it, to map out over your tree. And the parameter that I have chosen to look at is age at death, which I can either map out right here, and it's shown me the age at death for those for whom it's entered, or I could see a summary of it here, where I've included some names, and then it's giving me this cute display with the age at death. And I appear to have a fairly long-lived group of ancestors here. That's good. So back to my dashboard. The core offering at DNA Painter is a much more powerful data-driven series of analysis tools. Let's focus on two interrelated tools that help with tasks that many of us are ready for: figuring out how you're related to a match and identifying unknown ancestors. The Shared Sunny Morton tool is the first of these two and is based on data from nearly 60,000 known DNA relationships. I can use it to see what my amount of my shared Sunny Morton's with another match says about our possible genealogical relationships. I can view the chart here to see all the possibilities for the ranges that have been reported for these known relationships, or I can enter the total number of Sunny Morton's with an individual match. Here I'll enter 498 Sunny Morton's, which is based on the amount of DNA that Joe, the child of an adoptee, shares with an unknown match. So I should read all the different caveats here so that you understand exactly what the tool is and isn't telling you. After I consider those, I'm going to zoom in on the list of likely genealogical relationships based on the number of shared Sunny Morton's. Joe and this match do appear to be about the same age, which I know from a little bit of research, and if so, that likely puts them on the same generational level. So I'm going to say that this one strong possibility right here, the half-first cousin relationship, that would be on the same generational level. This doesn't mean that it's true. Just because they're the same age doesn't mean that they're on the same generational level, but it's a good starting theory. So I can enter this number here for lots of Joe's matches on this branch of their tree. I've also been doing genealogy to connect Joe's matches to each other. So now I'm ready to populate Joe's tree in What Are the Odds, commonly referred to as Watto. My goal is to find out how Joe might fit into the family tree of matches I've already constructed. So I've created this tree, and you can see that 498 Sunny Morton match Genealogically, I have learned that this person belongs here on this tree, and it's a half-sibling relationship to the other siblings in the family, which I discovered by doing genealogy, so I have labeled this person that way. And so that definitely opens the possibility of a half-cousin relationship for Joe somewhere on this tree. So I'm ready to hypothesize about where Joe fits into this tree after creating the tree based on what I've known of this, the genealogy of how the other matches are connected. I've entered the place on the tree and the Sunny Morton count for each of these four matches, and now I'm ready to see where Joe might fit. So I could add my own hypotheses by adding somebody and then identifying it as a hypothesis, but I'd like to see what the tool thinks based on the probabilities. Remember, this tool is called What Are the Odds? So I click to suggest hypotheses. And I see there are lots of possibilities. You will want to read the information here in the green box so that you understand what you're looking at, and possibly to refine your possibilities. You might be able to enter birth and death data, and you might be able to expand the possibilities by manually selecting somebody else as a hypothesis. But you're going to want to consider all these numbers here. Every number that's shown, every position that has a score, is a possibility based on the genetics and the odds, but the higher the score, the higher the probability that this is where Joe belongs on the tree. Based on the ages I know, I think that Joe belongs in this generation, and it looks like Watto is agreeing with me based on the probabilities. That would make Joe could be a first cousin, half first cousin to this match, which you recall was the most likely scenario suggested over at the Shared Sunny Morton project. You can see how these individual statistical probabilities of how Joe is connected to each of these people and then putting together the tree are coming together in Watto to suggest a bigger picture with multiple match relationships. So I'll keep doing genealogy on more matches and adding them here as I learn more about them and their possible parents. Meanwhile, there's a lot more to do on DNA Painter, including the chromosome maps, which we're not delving into today. You can do a lot of things for free. The things that I've shown you so far are available to free users, but you can also choose to become a subscriber to take advantage of premium options offered by site creator Johnny Pearl, a leading genetic genealogist. So if you haven't already, go get started at dnapainter.com.